seem to matter now. All those weapons destroyed. Oh, dear Lord, how we could have used those guns. Forgive me, I haven't been sleeping well lately.
I understand.
Sherman is exacting a terrible price from South Carolina for leading the way into secession. He must be worried about your family there.
Yes, there's been no communication with Charleston since the rail lines were cut, and that was weeks ago.
We have one small chance, Hurry.
Lee is facing almost double his number of troops, sir, and Johnston has an even worse situation in North Carolina.
Yes, I know, but if Lee could slip away from Grant's army and join up with Johnston over the Carolina border, both armies combined might be able to defeat Sherman. Then he could head north and meet Grant on something like equal terms.
It'll take a lot of luck, sir, and all the skill Lee can muster.
It's an outside chance at best, I know, but only one we have. Lee is set on trying it as soon as the roads are dry enough for him to move. He's gonna need every good man that we've got left.
Yes, sir.
May you serve him as well as you've served me and this government.
Goodbye, Mr. President.
God go with you, all right?
I assume you read my final report.
It's only final when you find my wife.
Sir, you have received a dozen detailed reports. Your wife has simply disappeared.
Well, you have to keep trying. You must have missed something.
Sir, I can't make a career out of one case. I have other clients.
Well, I don't give a damn about your other clients. I just want you to find my wife.
General, I know how you feel, especially with the war and all.
I'm sorry. I just can't give up. Please.
I'll do what I can.
See General Sherman.
I'm sorry, ma'am. The general never talks to civilians unless he sends for them.
Oh,
ma'am!
Ma'am,
off the carriage!
Ma'am! Attention!
Oh. I'm General Case, General Sherman's chief of staff. Is there something I can help you with?
Well, thank you, sir, but I must speak to the general personally.
I'm afraid that's impossible. The general sees no one without an appointment, and all his appointments are made through me.
Well, then I would like you to make one for me. Now.
General Sherman is the commanding officer of the entire army, madam.
Exactly. That is why I must see him.
Even if you were a relative, madam.
Kate! Let her pass.
I'll be damned.
Bill Sherman, ma'am. At your service.
Madeline Maine, General. I wonder if I might have a moment of private conversation with you.
Of course. Gentlemen, as you were.
I traveled a long way to see you, General.
You showed good spirit back there.
I had to. I understand. The city of Charleston was spared because of its beauty.
We didn't spare Charleston because of its beauty. We needed it for military use.
What of its people, General? Do you find them beautiful also? The victims of war, the innocent who have suffered. I have come here to ask for help for those people.
What would you have me do?
Thousands of refugees have fled to Charleston. The poor, the weak, the orphaned, those who have had no choice in the war, those who have perhaps suffered the most.
I had no choice either.
I've tried very hard to understand that, sir. I run a camp for refugees, mainly mothers, and their children who have nowhere else to go. Your armies have won the victory. Can you find it in your heart to help the conquered?
What kind of help, madam? Where is this place? How many are there?
It's on the outskirts of Charleston. There are hundreds, I'm afraid, and more every day. What we need most is food.
I'll ask Cates to take you to the quartermaster. You shall have provisions from us for your camp.
I knew if I spoke to you.
You are a woman of great courage. And courage nearly always wins.
Sniffing around Mount Royal, Mr. Jones.
Cuffy! Lord, am I glad to see you.
Yes, sir! Is your Cuffy all right? The nigger boy used to fuss and beat the work half to death.
I'm both now.
No, please, don't!
Respect, Mr. Jones. Respect for the boss of these woods. When all the white owners lickety-splitting off and Sherman's Yankees come through here like the biggest firestorm you ever did see. We're gonna be boss of this whole river.
Tell us.
What's left of these here plantations? It's gonna be mine. Take a bite, Mr. Jones. Or are you still too high and mighty to eat with a black donkey?
No. No.
Bite it now. We want you to complain about my hospitality.
All right.
Heard you join the Yankees. How come you...
They no different. At Hilton Head, they call me Private Cuffy. still put a shovel in my hand.
When war's over, you're gonna have to deal with those same white men. You're gonna need somebody who knows laws and squatters' rights, how to run a plantation. I got me a bunch of boys. Swamp rats know how to slit a throat better than your meanest buck. We're the same kind now, my friend. We need each other. Right?
One time. Let's talk. Salem.
Go on.
Here you are, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, may I help you, sir?
I'd like to see Congressman Green.
The congressman is busy.
Who is it, David?
It's a gentleman to see you, sir.
Yes, sir. I'm Officer Hughes. If I could have just a few moments of your time, in private. It's important.
David, please.
Yes. Take your hat, sir.
That'll be all, David.
Thank you.
Please.
Thank you. I understand that, you know a woman named Virgilia Hazard Grady.
Yes, as a matter of fact, I do. Some years ago, I helped her secure a position with Miss Dix's nursing corps. Please sit. I was deeply distressed to hear that a warrant had been issued for her arrest.
You had any contact with her?
Not for some time.
Sir, it is very important that we talk with Mrs. Grady. Perhaps you could help me find her.
That's exactly what I told him.
I think that was right.
Yes. Oh, here we are.
Hello. Good evening, Mr. Collins.
Good evening.
So nice of you to join us. Please come in.
Thank you.
Good evening. Pleasure to see you. Hello, we haven't met Congressman Sam Green. I believe you know the junior senator. Yes, my dear.
Please excuse me. I haven't had a chance to speak to Sam all evening.
The fair sex. A man can never leave them alone for too long. Will you excuse us, please? Yes.
Sam, the police are everywhere. They're asking questions about a woman with my description. What if my landlady...
Your landlady won't say anything. I pay her very good money for this house and for her silence.
But you said that you would take care of Mrs. Neal and you would get the murder charge dropped. That was months ago.
I'm doing all that can be done.
Oh, I'm not complaining, Sam. It's just that I thought that a man as important as you would be able to take care of it sooner. After all, I am innocent. I had nothing to do with that man dying.
I told you. These things take time.
Do you want to go into the study? I thought about this all day. About being alone with you.
Tell me more, Virgilia. What else have you thought about all day?
About what a wonderful lover you are?
Am I? Am I as good as Grady?
There's no one like you, Sam. No one.
Thank you.
ran around back to the outbuilding. Try to pull the torch.
What do you want here?
Major Fisk, ma'am. Kilpatrick's Cavalry Corps. I wish we could spare your house, but we can't. You could have everybody clear out, please.
Please, sir. My husband is an officer in your army. This is his house, too. You can't burn it.
This war is hard on everybody, ma'am.
There are only women here. We didn't start this war. We're just trying to survive it.
That's all any of us trying to do, ma'am. I'm sorry, but all of this has got to go.
We're not leaving.
You heard my daughter, Major.
Mother!
We're not leaving.
Sergeant! Carry them off the veranda.
You'll have to burn this house down around me.
No!
Sergeant, I think this house is close enough to Charleston that it was an excellent headquarters for our senior staff. Move the men out. Night, ladies.
Both sides read the same Bible and pray to the same God. And each invokes his aid against the other. The prayers of both cannot be answered. The Almighty has his own purposes. 17 states have ratified the amendment abolishing slavery.
Yesterday, I heard that the Confederate Congress in Richmond voted entire regiments of slaves into their army.
Well, the issue is all but finished now. We began this war to end it now. We cannot seem to end the war.
Under detail, color guard. Present, heart. Shoulder, turn. Left wheel, turn.
This is General Staff, sir.
Lieutenant.
Sheridan's cleaned out the last pockets of resistance in the Shenandoah Valley. He's got 12,000 cavalry here near Dinwiddie Courthouse. If he can make it to this junction, Five Forks, he'll be well beyond Lee's lines.
He'll need help.
I promised Sheridan an infantry corps, more if he needs it. Mr. President, I want Phil to take and hold Five Forks. He'll cut Lee's only railway south. I can get my troops between Lee and Johnson. If we can break through Lee's line here at Petersburg, we can force the city's evacuation. And then Richmond. The Confederacy would have to capitulate.
I believe we must give some thought to what happens then.
You mean our terms for peace, Mr. President?
Yes. We can't dictate harsh terms. Both sides share the blame for this war, as both have shared its terrible cost, and now both must share in the victory.
You mean let them up easy?
Yes, that's the way we put it when I was a boy.
Sir, are you saying we should just dismiss the Confederate armies?
I'd like to see all these men back to work on their farms and in their shops. I want civil governments reestablished in all the secessionist states as soon as possible.
Are you willing to deal with the state governments as they now exist, sir?
If we have to, yes. Until Congress can organize elections or establish some other permanent arrangement.
I'm afraid you won't be very popular in some quarters, Mr. President.
Well, I've never been very popular in some quarters, Sam.
Some people want the South to bleed for what it's done, sir.
The South has bled enough, General. So are we.
Billy, they'll fire the signal to advance from Fort Fisher.
How are we supposed to hear it in all
and
this?
And the bygone.
Company! Fall in!
Move, move! Let's go!
Let's go! Let's go.
What are your orders, General? Sir! General, what are your orders? The troops are ready. It's time, sir. George! Fire!
Sound the advance.
Thank you.
We gotta get out!
Said you're gonna make it, Tom. It's gonna take a little longer than you might have figured. I'm gonna stay with you a couple of days. And then I'll come back for you when you can travel. I know Brett's looking forward to meeting you. So you hurry up and get well. Remember, you're my friend, and I love you.
I knew you'd be concerned about your brother, George. The field surgeon says he's gonna be all right.
Thank you, sir.
Well, I couldn't find anything in the early casualty reports about General Maine. A few of their senior officers were killed, among them a Lee favorite, A.P. Hill, but not all the Confederate dead and wounded have been identified.
You know I'll appreciate anything you can do to help.
George, I want you in on this.
Yes, sir.
Gentlemen, I realize our army is exhausted, but Lee's men must be even more so. We cannot let them escape to North Carolina.
If he and Johnson can get their men into the hill, they can go on fighting from there for years. That would finally destroy our nation, sir.
Sir, you give me Generals Hazard, Ord, and Griffin. We'll ride without food or sleep to put an end to it, so help me God.
Phil, I don't want a series of bloody attacks on his rear. Don't just chase him, get on his flank so he can't turn south and then head him off. If we can get in his front, we'll bag the entire army. When Mr. Lincoln heard about our recent victories, he asked if his four-year nightmare was finally over. Let's make sure it ends at Lynchburg.
Hold your fire.
God, it's over. It's really over.
Wanted or expected such a terrible conflict. Both sides read the same Bible, pray to the same God, and each has invoked his aid against the other. But the Almighty has his own purposes. And if he now wills the removal of a great wrong that is slavery, and wills also that we of the North, as you of the South, should pay fairly for our complicity in that wrong, impartial history will find therein new cause to attest and revere the justice and goodness of God.
Thank you.
Sergeant Tucker, bring those horses around.
You must believe that, dear. I do, Mama. I have to.
Augusta! Washington! Augusta! Hey, fella. Augusta! Washington! Hello?
Washington. Where's Augusta? The house wouldn't be like this if she were here.
That's right, sir. If Miss Augusta see it this way, she'd be in a state. If she
was... She left, didn't she? Just like I asked her to do. She went to see her people in Charleston.
No, sir. She ain't in Charleston. Miss Augusta's dead. She died when the baby came.
The baby?
I made it myself when Boz was born. Miss Augusta's baby come early. Not supposed to get born for another month. There ain't no more doctors around here. So I fetched Mama Sarah, the midwife. She couldn't save Miss Augusta. I buried her like she wanted to.
What about the baby?
Miss Augusta's uncle and his missus knew about the baby. And after she was gone, he come up from Charleston and took the boy away.
That boy, he's my son.
Yes.
Why didn't she tell me, Washington? She had to have known the last time I was here.
She didn't want to worry you none.
She wanted me to tell you, sir.
She knew you loved her. And she loved you very much.
Help you, Major?
I'm Charles Maine.
I somehow knew you'd find your way here.
I know this must be very difficult for you, Mrs. Barclay. But I've come to take my son home.
He has your strength. Take care of him, sir. He's a fine boy.
I'll never let him forget his mother. Or you. Thank you for all you've done.
Mama's spirits. sir. What are you doing?
Fixing to leave. War over. I'm free. There ain't nothing left here for me now. It's time I find that new life.
Not without me. Bible all these years. In it, he tried to say what he had a hard time saying, that he loved me and his new son and would love and cherish all our children. Then he talked about this land and what it meant to him. And there's just this one little part I want to read to you. Mont Royal isn't just bricks and mortar and polished wood. The people who live here give it its real character. I've made mistakes in my life, done things I'm sorry for, but I've tried to live by a tradition of family unity, service to others, honor, and fair dealing. And it is my prayer that our children and their children and generations to come will carry on that tradition. There are two others here who have become so much a part of Mont Royal. They've decided to join their lives just as Tilly and I did so many years ago. Ezra, Semiramis, we all want you to have that corner section by the river to start a new life together.
I still haven't seen anything in the paper, Sam. When will you get the murder charges dropped?
I am sick of you harping on that, Virgilia.
Like I'm sick of servicing you? Oh, my God. I didn't mean that, Sam. I didn't. Believe me, Sam, you're the only friend I've got. Please forgive me, Sam. Please.
I forgive you.
Will I see you tomorrow, Sam?
Are you asking how soon I'll be back with more money?
You know I'm not asking that. I enjoy being with you, Sam.
Virgilia, the fact is, I won't be back tomorrow or any other day.
You can't mean that.
The party feels I will be the most effective candidate for the Senate. That means that knowing you is something of a risk. Someday, somebody's going to find out about us.
But you care about me, Sam. I mean something to you, don't I?
Do you really think I'd risk being ruined politically? No. My dear, you were a challenge. Like so many of life's challenges, once it's met, one moves on.
Sam, is this because of what I said earlier?
No. I made up my mind long before tonight.
I'd let you use me like one of your whores.
There's no need to be crude, Virginia. There's a brighter sign. Yes, I'll be free, but then again, so would you.
What do you mean?
You need no longer worry about the murder indictment against you. A policeman told me some time ago that a witness had come forward, a stretcher bearer, and he absolved you from any responsibility for that Southern officer's death. So the only thing you have to worry about is the assault charge against you by Mrs. Neal. That should prove to be minor inconvenience at best.
You knew all this and you just let me go in believing that my life was in danger?
Just collecting on past favors, my dear. You don't have to worry about moving immediately. The rent's paid to the end of the month. Excuse me. Virgilia. Take care. Goodbye, my dear.
Goodbye. No, not like this, Sam.
Hmm?
You're not leaving.
Virgilia, you're upset. And you don't know what you're doing.
I know exactly what I'm doing.
I did everything I can, Virgilia. I'm sorry there's no chance for reprieve.
It's just as well. I told him I wanted it over with as quickly as possible. Do you believe in fate, George?
Hmm?
If Grady lived, tomorrow would be our anniversary. And it's the day I hang. It's ironic, don't you think?
I know Mother really wanted to see you.
No, I'm glad you agreed with me. I think that it would have been too much for her. I can't believe I lost everything. I lost my pride, George. I sold it. This is my wedding ring. I was thinking that maybe you could give it to Hope someday. You could tell her it's from her crazy aunt.
She'll be proud to wear it. When we were little, I remember a boy who made fun of an answer you gave in class. And without mussing a hair, you knocked him down on the playground and made him admit that you were right. I admired you then for having the courage of your convictions. And I still do. I wish we could always have been close. I love you.
Mother's going to need us now more than ever.
I know. Thank you for coming, Reverend. I'm sure you've been a great comfort to my mother.
And she is much comfort to me. Your mother is a very strong woman, General Hazard. I'm sure she's just going to be fine.
Thank you. I'll see you out, Reverend.
Thank you.
General. Good idea.
She's at peace now. No matter what she did, I loved her. I always loved her.
I know, Mother. So did I.
I'm so sorry for all that you've had to go through, Mother.
What's important is that I have the two of you. And that one day we will be a family again.
Was it all a terrible waste? A needless violence that tore our country apart?
It was a price that had to be paid. But I'm afraid that it'll be harder to silence the hatred and the blame than it was to win the war.
The South has lost so much. So many lives to rebuild. The Maines will need us very much. Oh, I pray that Ari is alive.
He's the best friend I've ever had, Constance. I've got to find out what happened to him. The war will never be over for me.
Sorry to have kept you waiting so long, General.
I know how busy you are, Colonel. I realize the location of a particular body is not a priority for you.
We were flooded with dead and wounded after Petersburg. Some of them were never identified.
But surely somebody noted General Maine's rank or description.
I understand he was your best friend.
We were together at West Point.
I see you've been looking through our records.
Yes, and I've been through the personal effects of some of the Confederate dead, but I can find no identification of his body nor record of his burial.
It is possible that he may have been taken to a field hospital and died there, or the records might have been misplaced.
How can I find out?
I'm afraid all I can do is authorize you to visit the hospitals and be given their cooperation.
I would very much appreciate that, Colonel.
I'll tell my aide to draft a letter.
Thank you. Do you know anything of a Confederate General Maine?
No.
Good luck to you.
Patty. Last time we spoke, I told you to take care of yourself. You obviously weren't listening to me. Nobody was listening in those days. I was worried about you. I didn't know if you'd made it. You either. Charles? Heard he's fine. I don't remember anything. They said I was unconscious for days. What about Billy? Oh, he's probably halfway to Mount Royal by now. Get out of here, George. This rank ought to be good for something. I've got to find Madeline.
I'll bet she's home waiting for you.
You don't understand. I haven't seen her in almost 2 years.
What?
She just disappeared. I've hired detectives. The only thing I've been able to find out is that she sold her father's house to some Charleston lawyer.
Sorry, Ori, I'd like to...
Sergeant, what's all the commotion?
We just received word, sir. President Lincoln's been shot. He's not expected to live.
God, Ellis.
Oh, please, God.
George. I could really use your help right now.
One, two, one.
I know that my wife sold her house through you. You have to know where she is.
I'd like to help you, General Maine, but I have never in my entire life violated my word to anyone.
Madeline and I love each other, Mr. Colbert. Hasn't this war caused enough pain? Please, sir.
I could tell how much your wife cared for you, and that troubled me all the time I was holding my silence. And there has been enough pain.
Then you could tell me where she is?
I can no longer keep two people apart who should be together.
Thank you, sir.
You look so like your father sometimes. You do.
You really are here.
You must hate me for leaving you the way I did.
I know why Ashton told me.
Well, then you know why I had to leave. She said terrible things would happen.
Maybe that was true once. But you don't have to be afraid anymore. No one will ever hurt us again.
You mean you take me back?
I never wanted you to go. I love you, Madeline, and I always will.
I love you too. Please, Mommy, I love you too.
I do.
But I have to tell you. There's another man in my life now. Oh. Ori Nicholas Maine, your son.
That's a mighty big section of land you got there. I reckon you're gonna need a family to help you work it.
We've been thinking about that.
Well, you gotta do more than thinking.
Now, burn it.
I'll get the guns.
Mama?
Mom. 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 I had a baby, Mom. Your grandmother, Mom. 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 Please don't die.
And he said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. My mother lived to see her way of life disappear from the face of this earth. Yet she blamed no one, and she hated no one for it. Clarissa Main was a loving and compassionate woman. I think she would have agreed with Mr. Lincoln. With malice toward none and charity for all, let us strive to bind up the nation's wounds, to care for him who was born in the battle and for his widow and orphan, to do all which may achieve and cherish a just and lasting peace among ourselves and all nations.
Father didn't live to see this. I got married here, George. It was the happiest day of my life.
We can't fool ourselves by thinking it'll be easy to rebuild this country, Ori. It won't be. We've all suffered too much. But, in a way, our families have been blessed. And our friendships endured. So maybe it's up to us, in our own way, to start healing the wounds of this nation. I want to reinvest in our textile mill, Ori, and I want you to use the profits to rebuild Mount Royal.
You're the best friend a man could ever have, George.
We're a family, Ori. You remember that.